Hello students, welcome to You Maths class. I am sure you all are eager to learn new concepts with me. In previous class videos, we have learnt what are integers and operations of integers, like addition and subtraction. Today we are going to learn multiplication and division of integers. Before we start, let us have a quick revision of previous knowledge. Integers are the set of negative and positive numbers including zero. A set of integers are represented as a capital letter Z. A positive integer is greater than zero and the negative integer is always less than zero. Zero is defined as neither positive nor negative integer. The four basic arithmetic operations associated with integers are addition of integers, subtraction of integers, multiplication of integers, and division of integers. Before we start learning these methods of integer operations, we need to follow some rules for doing these operations. And we have to remember few things, like if there is no sign in front of a number, it means that the number is positive. For example, 5 means plus 5. In previous class, we have learned addition and subtraction in detail. Let us have a small recap. When you are adding same sign integers, take the same sign and add them. When you have a different sign of integer in addition, take the sign of largest value and then subtract. Let us recall subtraction rules. When you are subtracting two integers, change the subtraction sign to an addition sign, then change the sign of the second number into opposite number, then follow the addition rule. If you want to learn addition and subtraction in detail, there is a link available in description. Multiplication and division of integers are the most important arithmetic operations used often. Let us learn multiplication and division of integers in detail. Let us understand what rules we have to follow while doing multiplication of integers. First, concentrate on sign of integers. If the given multiplication of integers are both positive numbers, then the right the sign of product is also positive. For example, the given number is 2 multiplied by 5. Both numbers are positive numbers, so we are writing the sign is positive and the product of 2 and 5 is 10. If in the given integers both numbers are negative numbers, then to write a positive sign. Then write the product of those given numbers. For example, minus 2 multiplied by minus 3. In this case, both are negative numbers, then too we are writing the sign is positive and multiplication of 2 and 3 is 6. If in the given integer one positive and one negative number, then write the sign of negative and then write the product of given numbers. For example, minus 2 multiplied by 5. In this case, minus 2 is the negative number and 5 is the positive number. So, write the sign as negative and product of 2 and 5 is 10. So, answer is minus 10. The following table will help you to remember rules for multiplying integers. When both integers are positive, then the result is positive. When both integers are negative, then the result is positive. When one positive and one negative integer, then the result is negative. Isn't it easy? Students, remember always multiplying integer with zero gives zero. Let us learn division of integers now. It includes both positive numbers and negative numbers, just like multiplication. The division of integers the same rules. When you divide integers with two positive signs, you get positive integers. For example, 16 divided by 8. Here 16 and 8 both are positive numbers. So the answer is in positive integer. When you divide integers with two negative signs, then 2 you get positive integers. For example, minus 16 divided by minus 8. In this case, 16 and 8 both are negative integers. Result is in positive sign, that is plus 2. When you divide integers with one negative sign and one positive sign, the result is in negative sign. For example, minus 16 divided by 8. Here, 16 is a negative value and 8 is a positive value. So, the answer is minus 2 is in negative sign. Remember, we cannot divide any number by 0. Let us make these rules easy by writing in a tabular format. Keep in mind rules for dividing integers. While dividing integers, if both integers are positive in sign, the result will be in positive sign. If both integers are negative in sign, then too the result will be in positive sign. But if one positive and one negative sign, then the result will be in negative sign. In other words, we can say the quotient of two positive integer is positive. The quotient of two negative integer is also positive. The quotient of a positive integer and a negative integer is negative. Students, keep this in your mind. The two most important things to remember when you are multiplying or dividing two integers are: when the signs are the same, the answer is always positive. When the signs are different, the answer is always negative. Isn't it easy? I am sure you must have understood the concepts of multiplication and division of integers. As I always say, maths requires practice. Make sure you solve some practice questions from your textbook. If you have understood the concept, do not forget to hit the like button. If you have any question, leave a comment and I will answer you back as early as possible. Thank you for watching this video.